Hey everyone, welcome to the channel. So I reviewed Paranoid Android ROM for OnePlus 6 and 6T a couple of months ago, and it was good enough to be used as a daily driver. But I did face some occasional glitches here and there, as it was still a beta software. But last week, an official stable version was released for a few OnePlus and some other devices as well. So in this video, let's have a look at the stable version of Paranoid Android, that is Quartz 1. So before we begin, make sure you hit that subscribe button and press the bell icon next to it. It's free and helps the channel out. So I will include flashing instructions at the end of this video. So make sure you stay tuned till the end to know more about it. So right of the first boot, we have the new animation, and the system booted up just fine without any errors or so. One good thing about this ROM is that it has GApps, short for Google Apps, included in the ROM itself. So that's one less thing to do. Now looking at the features of this ROM. So out of the box, you get these inbuilt apps. The camera is AOSP based, so it doesn't have much features, and I would totally recommend a Google camera mod. You can find my recommendation on the top right corner. Now let's jump into the settings. First thing to notice is that it has April 2020 version of security patch, which is the latest, so that's cool. Apart from this, we have OTA support in Paranoid Android now. So you will get official weekly updates and monthly security patches. And you don't have to do anything to install them. And it's great since OxygenOS 10 on our devices just doesn't get timely updates anymore. Apart from this, you have those usual settings, always on display and ambient display. But those are very basic, so no customizations there. And you also have the edge lighting feature as well. So the edges of the display will light up as soon as you get a notification. Plus there is a pocket mode as well, to save you from accidental touches. Moving on, you have your usual system gestures and navbar to choose from. Plus the screen of gestures are also there, just like you had in OxygenOS. And 3-finger screenshot option is also present, just in case you started to miss OxygenOS 10 already. So these are the new features of this ROM. Now moving on to the overall stability and battery life. Well, the screen on time I got on this ROM was off the mark, with more than 6 hours of screen on time, which is just great. And I also did some gaming on this ROM. Well, I ran PUBG on extreme graphics and smooth settings to test for any heating issues or so. And as usual, the device did get a bit warm on the top, and that is expected on such settings. So nothing to worry about, as everything was normal as it should be. And you can definitely use this ROM as your daily driver. It's quite stable and contains almost all the features you had in OxygenOS. So it gets a thumbs up from my end. Now the instructions on how to install the ROM. So download the ROM from link in description area. Now boot to TWRP recovery. And if you're not on latest OxygenOS 10, flash the latest OxygenOS 10 first to get the maximum stability and avoid any boot loops and problems. So now go to the wipe option. Now swipe to factory reset. And for the last step, click on install button. Now flash the Paranoid Android ROM.zip file you just downloaded, and wait for a few minutes till the ROM installs. Now reboot to the system and you're done. So this was the full review of Paranoid Android Quartz 1, and the features will almost be same for all the devices. So like this video if it helped you out, and I'll see you guys in the next one.